You're going to love the new SAS Visual Forecasting 8.5 Forecast Viewer. It will let you see any time series, subseries, down to any level of a hierarchy. You can also look at actual data, predicted models, confidence intervals, and envelope plots. Let me show it to you. Here you can see the SAS drive window. If I go up to the hamburger in the top left, I can open the left pane where I'll find my build models. That will open my model studio window. Here in model studio, I select a new project. I'll call it forecast. I'm going to select the type of forecasting. I'll leave the default of auto forecasting. I'll browse to my data and I'll save it. We come into our data pane where we see the year SAS. It has a numeric time role and population has numeric and dependent variable role. So population is what is being forecast. If we move to the pipeline tab, we can see the pipeline here with data auto forecasting, model comparison, and output. We run our pipeline. So once the run has successfully completed, we go to our forecast node. In this case, it's auto forecasting. Right click, and we go to our forecast viewer. Here I'm looking at human population data from 1750 up until 2020. You can see the blue dots are the actual data. The blue line is the model. And from here forward, from this black vertical line forward, is the forecast. This blue shaded area is the confidence limit. I can hide the actual values. I can hide the confidence limits. I can show just actuals and predicted, or I could show just the actual values. This icon lets me see the overview axis, which shows up here at the bottom. I can also download my data by pressing this icon, and you see my CSV file shows down here at the bottom. I can open that CSV file, and you see I have my time ID values, my actual values, my predicted values, and my lower and upper confidence limits. This will give me my data not only for the historic data, but also for the forecast data. I can maximize my view. And here I have the option for envelope plots. But even though I have envelope plots checked on for both actual values and predicted values, I don't see any. Can you figure out why? Notice I only have one series here. So the envelope plots are going to be around the mean, and if I only have one series, it doesn't make any sense to have envelope plots. So let's look at a different example where I have a lot of different categories and I have a lot of different subseries. Here again, I'm looking at human population levels from 1950 through 2020. I have a lot more detail here, and I've included as attributes that I can filter on both region and sex. My regions include Africa, Asia, Europe, Latin America, North America, and Oceania. And I have the genders female and male. You can see by default, I have my envelope plots. Here, this gray dotted line is the mean. Around that, I have my one standard deviation in the dark shaded area. Then I have two standard deviations in the lighter shaded area. And finally, in the very lightest, I have the full range of the data. Now I can go to my envelope plots. And for example, let's say I want to get rid of my actual value envelope plot. So now I just have the predicted values envelope plot, and I'll get rid of that too. I can select any one of these series to view it, or I can select multiple series. In yellow, I have my Asian female population levels. In blue, I have my African female population levels. Purple, our European female population. The dark orange is Latin American. The green is North American. I can add my envelope plots back in if I would like. And maybe I want to get a little closer look at some of these lower numbers. So I'm going to deselect my Asian female population. And I can take a closer look and see that my African female population is increasing most dramatically. My European female population has leveled off. It looks like it leveled off in the 90s. And I can see that my Latin American female population is increasing much faster than my North American female population. I can subset these by any group. It doesn't matter whether my hierarchy has region down to sex or sex down to region, doesn't matter. I can select any of these subcategories and show them together. For example, let me look at North American females and male populations. I can see here that the North American female population in blue is higher than the North American male population. In summary, see that we have so many different options here. It makes it very handy, depending on what you want to focus in on. I have to say, I love this viewer. Finally, if I want to see my modeling results, I can look here and I can see them for each of my subseries. So I can see for my African female population, the model chosen was exponential smoothing model, and this here was my MAPE. If I look instead at Asian females, I can see I had a REMA model, and I had a MAPE of 0.008, or mean absolute percent error. For more information on SAS Visual Forecasting 8.5, check out the user's guide. Also, if you want to see the data sources that I use, they're available at these links. I hope this was helpful.